lunchtime, and I'm just trying to give everybody a chance to log in, and I got a question in my inbox, and I say, this one deserves a video. I gotta make a video about this one, because sometimes I just think as women, we are in denial. Like, I had multiple questions this week, and to everybody that sent me a question, I just wanted to say, are you walking around on earth like me? Like, because what you're going through, you don't have to go through, and it's plain as day, you know. Like, I'm just trying to figure out, at what point did we break, where did we lose it when instilling in our daughters their worth? Where did we lose that? What part did we start telling our daughters just to settle and take anything off of a person? I'm really trying to find out, where did we lose our way when raising our daughters? Because I'm 37 and I have a daughter that's 18, and she has self-worth, and she knows that she is not about to enter into something and just let somebody do her any kind of way just to say you got somebody. So I'm just trying to figure out who raised y'all? Because Claudette raised me, and if anybody that know, my mama knew that she was hard on the man. I mean, hard on the man. She ain't take no shit off no man. And, you know, it was very simple. Shit. Either you gonna do what the fuck she needs you to do, or you gonna move the fuck around, and she gonna find somebody that's gonna do what the fuck she need them to do. So, when these women inboxing me and they sending me these questions, and they just seem so weak behind a man, it's hard for me to wrap my mind around it, because I was raised by a certain type of woman, and the woman that raised me wasn't gonna just let you do her no any fucking thing. Like, you not gonna come to my shit and lay up on me and not have a job. Like, okay, I could understand you in your 20, maybe 25. You know, you still trying to find your way a little bit. But shit, if you motherfucking 30 years old, 35, and you still trying to get it together, something wrong. How you at this age and you ain't never had a lease in your name? How you this age and you ain't never had a light bill in your name? How you this age as a man and never had your own transportation? And you from woman to woman to woman, and the only way you could get around is to drive whatever woman you with car. I don't understand this. Why are y'all even considering men like this to be your man? These men ain't ready to be no man for nobody. And I'm not bashing men, because let me tell you something. I love men. But I'm talking about a man that's a real man. See, a man that understands that when he take up on a woman, he taking up on a responsibility. When he take up on a woman, he's saying, I'm taking a lead role to make sure you straight. See, you ain't supposed to be making sure he's straight. Yeah, I need y'all to start liking and sharing this shit and tagging y'all fucking friends in this, because some of them bitches need to hear this shit. Because it's just too many young women that's sending me messages about a motherfucker that ain't even got shit to contribute to them. And no, I ain't all about a dollar, but goddamn, if I'm getting up and I'm making shit happen, you need to be making some shit happen too. So this is what kind of got me. This woman says that, I'm gonna go over the first one. She say, he say he a polygamist. Polygamist means that he desires more than one woman. I ain't got a problem with that. I don't have a problem with a man being polygamous. I just think that you're supposed to tell the people that you're dealing with that you're polygamous in the beginning. That's the only thing. But this is what she get funky, okay? When you a polygamous man, it means that, yeah, you can have multiple women, but it also means that you can afford to take care of all of them fucking households. See, you won't be no polygamous man talking, we're running around using the term polygamous, because you need shelter from this woman. You need to use this woman's transportation. This woman got churn and food stamps, so she making sure you fed over here. And this one here, washing your clothes and buying your clothes and buying your shoes. No, motherfucker, you ain't polygamous. You a motherfucking user. I call it how I see it. That ain't polygamy. Polygamy mean I'm a man, I like more than one woman, and I can afford to take care of each and every last one of them. I can afford to add to each and every last one of these women that I'm dealing with, I can add to their household. That's what the fuck polygamy mean. So this shit y'all on is some new age pimp type shit, and y'all letting these motherfuckers pimp y'all and make fucking fools out of y'all. Because ain't no way if you telling me I'm a motherfucking polygamist, I got to give you any fucking thing. Yeah, I can accept that you laying dick down all of these different households, but my household ain't about to lack, and you ain't about to withdraw from mine without the poisonous of men. Next scenario. Oh, Miss Sharonda, I'm friends with this man, and we've been friends for 6 years, and in them 6 years, he got into a relationship with another woman, but I'm still getting the text messages in the morning. He's still dropping lunch off to the job. We still spending time together. We still doing this. We still doing that. What is the problem? Baby, the problem is he ain't choose you. You ain't the one. Because if you was the one, he wouldn't have started something else while he was dealing with you. See, he know that you're going to allow him to do whatever it is that he wants to do. And you're not going to require anything. So being that you're not going to require anything, it's easy. So he chooses to continue to play these little games with you. Ladies, I need y'all to instill some self-worth in y'all daughters. I really need you to do that. Because the shit that they accepting is unacceptable. It's unacceptable on all kind of levels. So I need you to instill some self-worth in your daughters. And let them know that a man is supposed to be responsible. They should not be taking care of no man. The man is supposed to be the responsible person. If he meeting you, and he's still trying to get all of his shit together in life, you let him get his shit together from a distance. Okay? I'm going to wrap this up. I hope it answered the question. But y'all got to really start instilling some self-worth in y'all daughters, because they just taking too much shit, and I don't understand why they taking it. I don't. So, I'm going to see y'all at 3 o'clock.